In this lesson, we will learn about subject-verb agreement.
Hello, my name is Sunil. I am going to the stadium to watch the football match with my friends. This is my friend Chris. Chris and I are going to the stadium together. We love playing football.
Everyone is heading to the stadium. Today's match is very important. Is Rafiq coming to watch the match?
Neither Rafiq nor Roy is coming. Rafiq is not feeling well and Roy is going somewhere with his parents.
Okay, I hope Rafiq gets well soon. Let's hurry, Sunil, or we will miss the match.
Yes, Chris, let's hurry.
Let's take a look at the sentences we just heard. I am going to the stadium to watch a football match with my friends. Chris and I are going to the stadium together. Everyone is heading to the stadium. Neither Rafiq nor Roy is coming. In each sentence, the part that is underlined is the subject. The part in italics is the verb. Did you notice how the verb in each sentence changed its form according to the subject? We call this subject-verb agreement. Let's learn more about it. Every sentence has a subject and a verb. The subject of a sentence is the person, place, thing, or idea that is doing or being what the verb describes. The verb is the word that describes an action by or state of the subject. Let's take an example. Our school conducts a donation drive every year for an orphanage. The subject here is our school. The verb is conducts. Our school talks about one school. Therefore, it is a singular subject. So, the verb conduct takes its singular form conducts. The basic rule of subject-verb agreement is that a singular subject takes a singular verb and a plural subject takes a plural verb. The student sings so wonderfully. The students sing so wonderfully. This girl has finished her work. These girls have finished their work. Let's look at some more rules of subject-verb agreement. The words between the subject and the verb do not affect the agreement. For example, the girl who is wearing a dark blue pair of trousers is my sister. The girl is a singular subject and hence takes a singular verb is. Although the word trousers is closer to the verb and sounds like a plural noun, it is not the subject. Hence, it does not affect the verb. Let's look at another example. The car with many riders was speeding towards the junction. The subject, the car, is singular. So, the verb was speeding is also singular. Let's see what happens when we have a compound subject, that is, more than one subject. A compound subject usually takes a plural verb. My friend and I are going to the stadium. This sentence contains two subjects. So, the verb to be takes its plural form are. Let's look at an exception to this rule. In sentences that contain the structure either or, the verb always agrees with the subject closer to it. Either my parents or my brother is at home. In this sentence, the subject brother, which is singular, is closer to the verb. So, the verb is singular. Let's rewrite the sentence as, either my brother or my parents are at home. The subject, my parents, which is plural, is closer to the verb. So, the verb is plural. Sentences using neither nor and not only but also construction also follow this rule. In sentences with indefinite pronouns as subjects, the verb is always singular. Each student was given a participation certificate. Someone has stolen my pen. In sentences that contain collective nouns, the verb is usually singular. Our team is practicing for the concert. Here, the members of the team are acting as one unit. So, we use a singular noun. Let's look at another example. The pack of dogs were running off in different directions. In this case, the members of the crew are behaving as individuals. So, we use a plural verb. Let's look at some more exceptions. If the sentence contains a prepositional phrase such as one of my friends, the verb is singular even though the word friends is plural. We must treat the prepositional phrase as a whole. One of my friends is a doctor. Similarly, with titles of movies or books, we use a singular verb. The Three Musketeers is a wonderful book. Now, let's take the example of gerunds. Gerunds are nouns derived from verbs by adding ing. They can be treated as any other noun. Gerunds are always singular and take a singular verb. When two or more gerunds are linked by and, they take a plural verb. Donating food to an orphanage helps the needy. Swimming and running are my favorite exercises.
So students, I hope that you have understood all the things by this video. The video was regarding subject-verb agreement. Okay, our topic is regarding subject and the verb. Now, what do you understand by the subject? Subject are those words from which the sentence begins. Subjects are those words from which the sentence begins. Okay, and verbs, there are helping verbs or auxiliaries verb, or there are main verbs. Now, look at here. I am going to the stadium to watch a football match with my friends. Second one is Chris and I are going to the stadium together. Third one is everyone is heading to the stadium. And the fourth is neither Rafi nor Roy is coming. So we can see that the words that are underlined. Which words are underlined? Here I is underlined. Chris and I underlined, everyone underlined, and neither Rafiq nor Roy. This is underlined. Then these underlined words are subjects. Now, the verbs are used according to the subject. जो verb होती है वो subject के according use होती है. In first sentence the subject was I. That's why we have used am. In second there were two subjects, Chris and I. Means two persons are there. That's why we have used are. If we see the third sentence, then there is everyone. Then the verb which is used is. In fourth sentence, neither Rafiq nor Roy. Two subjects are there, but we have used is. Now you will say why you have used is, then we will see it in the further form. and the verb is known as subject verb agreement. Every sentence has a subject and a verb. हर sentence में subject और verb दोनों ही present होते हैं. The subject of a sentence is the person, place, thing or idea that is doing or being what the verb describes. Subject can be anything. Either a subject can be person or a place or a thing or an idea. Okay, the verb is the word that describes an action by or state of the subject. Verb को words होते हैं जो कि action को describe करते हैं. This you all know the difference between the subject and the verb. Okay. Now next, which is mentioned in this video, is that our school conducts the donation drive every year for an orphanage. Okay, then our school is the subject and the verb that is used is conducts. S is there with the main verb, and you have already learned that when S is there in the main verb means the subject is singular. Our school is a singular subject, that's why we have used verb conducts. Okay. Next, a singular subject takes a singular verb and a plural subject takes a plural verb. You already know this, that if the subject is singular, the student, singular subject, that's why the verb will be singular, sings. The student, subject is plural, then there will be sing. The girl, singular subject, that's why we have used has. These girls, plural subject, that's why we have used have. Okay. Next, the words between the subject and the verb do not affect the agreement. The words that are present between the subject and the verb, they do not affect the agreement. Rule will be same. Singular subject, singular verb, and plural subject, plural verb. The girl who is wearing a dark blue pair of trousers is my sister. Singular subject, the girl, that's why we have used is. Is ke paas trousers are there, but का कोई इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ेगा. ओके, इफ देयर विल बी सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट देन देयर विल ऑलवेज बी सिंगुलर वर्ब. द कार विद मेनी राइडर्स वाज स्पीडिंग टुवर्ड्स द जंक्शन. द कार, दिस इज सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव यूज्ड वाज. सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट, सिंगुलर वर्ब. ओके, इफ देयर विल बी कार्स देन देयर विल बी वॉर. Okay, next, compound subject. What do you understand by the term compound subject? More than one subject is known as compound subject. Okay, my friend and I are going to the stadium. My friend, one subject, I, second subject. More than one subject are known as compound subjects. That's why we have used are, because there are two subjects. Okay, next, the structure either or the verb always agrees with the subject closer to it. If either is also present in the sentence and or is also present, then helping verb be according to the nearest subject. Either my parents or my brother is at home. Either my parents or my brother is at home. Now there are two subjects. Which are two subjects? First one is parents and second one is brother. Lekin sentence mein either and or use ho raha hai. Jin sentences mein either and or use hota hai bachcho, wahan par helping verb nearest subject ke according lagti hai. Wahan par helping verb nearest subject ke according lagti hai. Agar hum parents ko dekhe to wo ek plural subject hai, to helping verb are use hogi. But helping verb के ज्यादा पास कौन है, near कौन है, brother. Brother is a singular subject. That's why we have used is. If you see the second sentence, then it's written either my brother or my parents are at home. अब helping verb के ज्यादा near कौन है, parents. Parents is a plural subject. That's why we have used are. So in short, we can say that if the sentence either or is present, then the helping verb is used according. according to the nearer subject. Neither nor and not only but also. In the same thing, neither and nor, this rule is applicable. Indefinite pronouns as subject, the verb is always singular. In indefinite pronouns, the verb is always singular. Each student was, we don't know the student. Each student, indefinite pronoun, that's why we have used was. Collective nouns, if we talk about the group, a team or collection, in that the verb is always singular. Our team is practicing the concert. We are talking about a complete team. That's why we have used is. Okay, for collective noun, always a singular verb is used. A pack of dogs were running. A pack of dogs. That's why we have used was. Running off in different directions. Got it? Next. A prepositional phrase such as one of my many friends, the verb is singular even though the word friends is plural. We must treat the prepositional phrase as a whole. Yahan par friends likha hua hai, so there should be plural verb, but one of my friends. Sabke beech mein se humne kisi ek ki baat ki, one of my friends. That's why there will be singular verb. With titles of movies or books, we use a singular verb. A singular verb is always used with the Three Musketeers is a wonderful book. Now the name of the book is The Three Musketeers. So that's why we have used is. Now gerunds. Gerunds are nouns derived from verbs by adding ing. Gerunds जो है वे nouns होते हैं जो कि verb से derive होते हैं जिनके पीछे ing लगा होता है. They can be treated as any other noun. Gerunds are always singular and take a singular verb. When two or more gerunds are linked by, then they take a plural verb. अगर gerund singular है, donating food is at an orphanage helps the needy. This is singular subject, singular gerund, that's why we have used singular verb. Swimming and running, two gerunds are there, that's why we have used are. Now the topic is finished, subject, verb, agreement. If you have any kind of doubt, then you can ask me. Okay, have a nice day.